हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, दिस इज सुप्रिया मुगले, असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर एट सेंटर फॉर डिस्टेंस एजुकेशन, शिवाजी यूनिवर्सिटी, कोल्हापुर। आई एम हेयर टू डिस्कस अबाउट असेंबली लाइन बैलेंसिंग। दैट इज, इन दिस वीडियो वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न प्रोसीजर फॉर बैलेंसिंग द लाइन, मीन्स हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू बैलेंस द असेंबली लाइन। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियो वी हैव लर्न वॉट इज असेंबली लाइन, वॉट इज असेंबली लाइन बैलेंसिंग, और the exact problem in the assembly line, the objective of this concept, etc. And in this video we are going to learn how you are going to balance the assembly line. So before starting this video, I would like to ask you that if my speed of teaching is very high, then you can tell me in the comment section, or whether it is high or low, anything you can suggest me for improvement of myself. Okay, and if this video you think it is really very fast, or the speed is really very fast, then you can go to the settings and you can adjust the speed, okay, as per your suggestion. I will do, I will try my level best. Okay, so we'll start. Method or procedure of balancing the assembly line. Now, how you are going to balance the assembly line? The first step is identify the tasks, means whichever product you are going to manufacture, there are various types of activities. Okay, so you have to identify what type of tasks are included in that procedure. For example, pencil, you are going to manufacture a pencil, then it needs wood and it needs a lead, and then you are going to have that process, you know, designing or the length of the pencil and inserting the lead in that, or everything regarding that pencil. There are so many tasks, so you have to list out that task. Then next step is identify the precedence requirement, means you have to identify the important tasks between that. You have listed now the various types of activities in that process. Now you are going to have the preferential list, means you should prefer the important task. For which task you are going to prefer, means only important task you have to identify. Then step 3 is calculate cycle time and determine theoretical minimum number of work stations. So cycle time means the time is required to complete that task at one workstation. Okay, so that you have to calculate. Now how to calculate this? There are formulas I would like to tell you. Yes, cycle time is equal to available time divided by output requirement. For example, the pencil. Okay, available time means in 5 days I have to manufacture 100 pencils. Okay, this is one example I'm saying. Available time is 5 days. Okay, you can write in hours. And required output means 100, okay, 100 pieces I want to manufacture in 5 days. So after dividing that, you will get the cycle time. Then theoretical minimum number of workstations. Now theoretical minimum number of workstations is equal to all tasks time divided by cycle time. Now cycle time you have you have calculated, and all tasks time means all the tasks you have identified for this process. You are going to calculate all the task time and divide it by cycle time. You will get minimum number of workstations. The next step is compute the actual number of workstation by rounding up the theoretical number of workstation to the next higher integer value. Now you have calculated theoretical number of workstation, right? In the previous slide we have seen the formula. Now you have a theoretical number of workstation. What they have said, compute the actual number of workstation by rounding up, means suppose this value is in fraction. For example, 5.6 something is there, so you are going to rounding up, means 5.6 is equal to 6, or suppose 5.5 4 is equal to, you are going to rounding up like 5, means the next higher integer value. Then step 5 is assign the task to the workstation beginning with station 1 and moving from left to right through the precedence diagram. So in this step, they have said that preferences should be given to the important task first. Okay, you have identified the important task in the step 2, and now you are going to assign the task to them first, moving from left to right. Okay, and then remaining time you are going to assign to the other workstations. Okay, step 6 is after each time assignment, determine the time remaining at the current workstation by subtracting the sum of times for tasks already assigned to the workstation from the cycle time. Now you have assigned the task to the workstations who are important. Okay, means preferences you have given to the important task first. Now you are going to determine the time remaining at the current workstation by subtracting the sum of times for the tasks already assigned and the workstations for the cycle time. You are going to have subtraction between them, and then whichever the time remaining, you are going to assign that. Then step 7 is continue assignment of tasks until all tasks have been assigned to the workstations. That means you are going to continue this step. You have to give task to all the workstation, and suppose if one workstation is taking more time to complete that work, then we will assign other tasks to other workstations, so they will not have to be idle. Okay, means it is to be continued until there is no ideal time. If suppose one workstation is working very fast and before the previous one is taking more time, so next workstation will have to work, then you are going to give some other tasks to the second workstation. Okay, so that there is no ideal work time or ideal time. Then step 8, that is last step, is calculate idle time. Okay, whatever the idle time you will find in your process, you can calculate that. Then percentage of idle time and the efficiency of balancing the line. Means here, after assigning all the tasks, after starting the process, you will get the idea that in which workstation there is idle time. You can calculate that, make a percentage of that, and then you can identify the efficiency of balancing the line. Suppose if there is any ideal time at any workstation, then you can have plan for that. You can have some measures. You should have some corrective actions on that, so that there is no ideal time. So this is the procedure of assembly line balancing, where you have to balance the workload across the workstation, and so that workstation has optimum utilization and no idle time. So here I complete my video. I hope you understood the concept, how they are going to balance this assembly line. Really very easy. Just you have to remember the steps, the sequence of the steps and formulas, that is cycle time and minimum number of workstation. Two formulas are there. Okay, so try to write down one example in the exam, so that you can understood, or it is really very easy to explain on the basis of example. If you write example in the exam, so you can write easily the next step. You will understand that. Okay, so here I complete my video. Thank you so much.